Kids, today I'm going to explain you chapter number 13, that is, A Shelter So High. Aims and objectives. To tell the children about people living on hills. To tell the children about different states which come in between while traveling from Mumbai to Jammu and Kashmir. Difficulties faced by people living in hilly areas. Gaurav Jani lives in Mumbai. He was going to a journey on highest road of India, that is Ladakh. The journey took about 2 months. He kept all essential things on his motorcycle, loaner, and left Mumbai, passing through small villages and towns of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan and Haryana to reach Delhi. Look at the picture, children. He is Gaurav Jani with his loaner, his partner, his motorcycle, his best friend, his everything. Gaurav Jani liked to travel to different parts of our wonderful country, that is India. He is going on amazing journey on the highest road in India. This journey took about 2 months. He had to carry everything on his motorcycle. He packed a small tent, sleeping bag, plastic sheet, warm clothes, and food that would remain fresh for some days. He also took camera and extra cans of petrol. Gaurav Jani with his loaner left Mumbai, passing through small villages and towns of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan and Haryana to reach Delhi. It took him 3 days to cover 1400 kilometers from Mumbai to Delhi. He was hoping to see something new in Delhi, but it looked just like Mumbai. So, children, it took Gaurav Jani 3 days to cover 1400 kilometers from Mumbai to Delhi. He was hoping to see something new and different in Delhi, but Delhi looked just like Mumbai. He was tired of looking at the same kind of houses made of cement, bricks, glass and steel. He was looking forward to journey ahead. He was excited that he would be able to see wooden houses, houses with sloping roofs and those covered with snow. He had seen pictures of such houses in many books. Then he started his journey from Delhi to Manali, which took 2 days to cover. It was very refreshing in the mountains and the air was clean. Now, children, Gaurav Jani packed more things in Delhi and continued. In 2 days, he was in Manali. It was so refreshing to be in the mountains and breathe the clean air. Now, the real journey was to begin. Children, do you know Manali, which is in Himachal Pradesh, is a hilly area? Yes, it is hilly area. From Manali, he travelled through difficult roads of Jammu and Kashmir to reach Leh in Ladakh. Between his journey, he put up his tent to protect himself from cold night air. He keep his loaner outside the tent. Now, children, he was covering long distances each day and all he needed was food and a tent to protect himself from the cold night air. His nylon tent was so small that he could just about fit in it to sleep. His loaner stood as a guard outside the tent. Cold desert. At last, he reached Leh. He saw a high, dry, flat area called a cold desert. Now, children, he reached Leh. For the first time, he saw such an area, very high, dry, and flat, which is known as cold desert. He also saw high snow-capped mountains and a cold, flat ground. Do you know, children, Ladakh gets very, very little rainfall. In Leh, as he rode slowly, he was being followed by a group of children who were saying, "Jule, Jule." It means, welcome, welcome. So, after seeing Gaurav Jani, all the children gathered and started saying, "Jule, Jule." It means they were welcoming Gaurav Jan. Tashi, one boy, dragged Gaurav to his home. Now, as I told you children, Tashi dragged Gaurav Jani to his home. It was a building with two floors and made of stones. Walls were coated with thick layer of mud and lime. In ground floor, animals, hay and necessary things were kept, and on the first floor they used to live. The ground floor has no window, so when it gets too cold, they move to ground floor. Thick tree trunks were used to make the roof strong. Tashi took Gaurav Jani to the roof of the house. What a view! Gaurav Jani could see the same flat roofs all around. On some roof, red chilies were laid out to dry. And on some, there were pumpkins and yellow corn. Some roofs had stacks of paddy. On some, cow dung cakes were laid to dry. During summer, they dry many fruits and vegetables and store for winters. This Tashi told to Gaurav Jani. Now, Gaurav Jani started climbing higher. After Leh, he started climbing higher. He was moving towards the rocky plains of Changthang at a height of 5,000 meters. Children, do you know the meaning of Changthang? It means a place where very few people live. For many days, he kept wandering, but he did not find a single human being. Suddenly, he saw flat, grassy land. Many sheep and goats were grazing there. He also saw some tents. The Changpa tribe living on mountains. Gaurav Jani met Namgyal. He told Gaurav Jani about Changpas. Changpas move from one place to another with their goats and sheep and get milk, meat, skin for tent, wool for coats and sweaters from them. Children, these Changpa, a tribe, lives on Changthang. Changthang is a place where this tribe is found. Now, Gaurav Jani met Namgyal and came to know about the Changpa, a tribe living on the mountains. The Changpa tribe has only about 5,000 people. The Changpas are always on the move with their goats and sheep. It is from these they get all that they need. Milk, meat, skin for tents and wool for coats and sweaters. Their goats are their only treasure. It means their livelihood are their sheep and goats. Changpas graze their goats at higher altitude to get softer fur, that is hair. And do you know, children? Their big cone-shaped tent are known as rebo. The place where Changpa keep their animals इज कॉल्ड लेखा। फेमस पश्मीना। वर्ल्ड फेमस पश्मीना इज मेड फ्रॉम द फर ऑफ शीप एंड गोट्स फाउंड एट हाई एल्टीट्यूड्स लाइक चांगथा। चिल्ड्रन, एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर ऑल्सो, चांगथांग इज अ प्लेस एट अ हाइट ऑफ 5,000 meters, एंड शीप एंड गोट विच आर फाउंड एट वेरी हाई एल्टीट्यूड हैज वेरी सॉफ्ट एंड वार्म हेयर, एंड फ्रॉम द हेयर ऑफ दीज गोट्स एंड शीप द वर्ल्ड फेमस पश्मीना इज मेड। इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट पश्मीना शॉल इज एज वार्म एज 6 sweaters. द फाइन हेयर कैन नॉट बी वोवन ऑन मशीन, सो वीवर्स ऑफ कश्मीर मेड दीज शॉल्स बाय हैंड। After almost 250 hours of weaving, one plain pashmina shawl is made. Towards Srinagar. After spending few days with Changpas, Gaurav Jani went to Srinagar. He came across many things. Many families in Srinagar live in Donga, which can be seen in Dal Lake and Jhelum River. He saw beautiful houseboats with beautiful carvings on the wood on the ceiling, as you can see the picture given below. Here, beautiful carving is shown. Do you know, children? Tourists who come to Srinagar love to stay in houseboats. Houseboats can be as long as 80 feet and around 8 to 9 feet wide. In villages of Kashmir, houses are made from stones cut and kept one on the top of the other and coated with mud. Wood is also used. The houses have sloping roofs. Why houses have sloping roofs? Do you know, children? As it is very cold and hilly area, so many times there we find snow. That is why here the houses have sloping roofs. Some old houses have a special type of window which comes out of the wall. This is called dab. It has beautiful wood pattern. It is a wonderful to sit here and enjoy the view. The old houses in Srinagar are made of stones, bricks and wood. The doors and windows have beautiful arches, those known as mihrab. Some old houses have special type of window which come out of the wall called dab, as I told you earlier also. The old houses here are made of stones, bricks and wood with sloping roof. The doors and windows have beautiful arch. Now, after a long journey, Gaurav Jani reached his place, Mumbai. So children, after a long journey, Gaurav reached Mumbai. His heart felt heavy, but he was happy, as he had learned and experienced so many new things. He had also brought back some memories in camera. But this was not the end for Gaurav Jani. Next time, when he get bored of the city, he will again set out for a new journey. This was all about Gaurav Jani's journey. Now children, I hope you understood the chapter well. Thank you.